Let me show you how to manage any website like a real professional by using SSH access. SSH stands for Secure Shell. It's a secure protocol that is letting you to connect and control any other computer over the internet. The SSH logic is very simple. To connect to a remote machine, the same SSH key must present inside of your local machine as well as the other remote machine where you're trying to connect to. The port number 22 is used for SSH by default. However, sometimes this port might be slightly different. For instance, Webhost Most offers port 2323 for SSH access. So let me show you how to generate an SSH key using Terminal and then later add it to your web hosting account. Attention Windows users! Since Windows operating system is different than Linux and Mac, the procedure of generating SSH key on Windows is slightly different. So I have attached a link for all the Windows users down below this video to help you understand how it's done on Windows. If you're not a Windows user and you have Mac or Linux, let's dive straight into our terminal. First thing we need to do is log in as a root user. For that, we have to type sudo su. Type your password if it's gonna ask you. If no, then you're already inside of a root user. Next thing, we actually have to generate that key. So for that, we have to use the command, which is ssh -key gen --t --rsa --b-4096. It's gonna ask us about the location. Just leave it default. Do not use any passphrases and just leave everything by default. All right, so it has generated the key for us. The default location for the key is inside of the .ssh folder of the root user. We have to navigate to another folder, which is dedicated specifically for SSH. So cd --.ssh. And from here, type ls-al to list all the files. And we can see that we have here this ID RSA pub. This is our SSH key that we have to take and copy into our machine that we are trying to connect to. The easiest way to get this key out is by command cat. So let's type cat ID RSA.pub. Copy the information of this file. And next thing, now let's log into our web control panel. Select service that you're trying to manage. And before I move on, let me show you here on the tab hosting information, I have server name. And this is important because when I'll be connecting with SSH, I would have to specify the IP address, or in my case, I can use the server name. And this is my username. Username is important because we'll be using that to connect using SSH as well. So we know that here on this tab, we have our username and here we have our server name. We need these two parameters to connect to. But before that, let's log into our direct admin and add the key that we have just copied to the system. So that way we can connect our SSH to our specific account. Now let's open Security Management tab, you'll see SSH keys. Click that and you see that I have no SSH keys yet. Public keys and authorized keys are empty. Now let's go to paste key. Do not generate another key, because if you click that button, the system itself is going to generate a new key for you, but you don't need that because we already have one. So let's just paste it. Paste the key and click create. Wait a few seconds. Open this tab, authorized keys, and you can see that we have successfully added the SSH key that we have generated from our local machine to our web server. And now let's navigate back to our terminal and let's see if we can use this SSH command to log into our account. But first of all, let's grab our username, just copy the name. Now let's navigate back to terminal and we'll need those credentials right now. So type SSH space your username @ and the server name that you're trying to connect to. In my case, this is server 2, so I have to type server2.webhostmost.com, and then we have to specify the port number. Remember I told you that the port number is different, and this is how we do it, -p2323. This is our custom port. Click enter and it will ask you only once to continue, so just click yes. And as you can see, we are inside of our remote machine right now, because if I will type ls to list all the files, you will see that I have files that belong to my web hosting. And it actually says the username that I'm using right now. This is the one that I have copied from the web hosting. It indicates that I'm inside of my File Manager. And for reference, let's have a look what's inside of our public HTML file. We can navigate through CD, domains. This is our domain. And this is public HTML for our domain. We have just the default files here. And as you can see, we have successfully set up the SSH access and I can easily manage the remote machine. If you want to exit, just type exit and now we're back inside of our local machine. This is how we do it. So if this video was informative, hit the like button, subscribe to the channel and stay tuned for more videos.